Hello once again, YouTube, and welcome back to The Domain. Today, it's episode one of a four-part video series. I managed to get very luckily recently off eBay four different fire teams, and these are 100% complete, which is really kind of rare in Halo Mega Construx, right? Like, usually you buy stuff on eBay, it's 99% complete, we never really know. These are apparently 100% complete fire teams from across the years. We've got Sierra Squad, which is honestly the rarest of them all, I'd say, the most expensive. Five Halo 4 Marines, like, that's a really great deal. Then we've got Fireteam Eagle, also five figures, really nice. Fireteam Crimson and Fireteam Venom. And as you know by the title of this video, this is part one. This is Fireteam Venom unboxing and review. And I'm excited about this, particularly because this is quite nostalgic for me. I'm sure it's gonna be nostalgic for a lot of you guys out there, because Fireteams were like the very first thing Mega did when they got the new articulation. Like, they were just bringing it in. The new articulation, if you didn't know, was like part of the deal for Mattel buying Mega Construx. They like wanted to showcase that new articulation was like going to be the new thing and was going to be worth Mattel investing in when they bought the company. You know, Mega Bloks had hit a bit of a standstill where you couldn't really innovate any further with the figures. Like, they were so limited. So Mega decided to take a very daring step, honestly, and completely rebrand themselves with new articulation. We got new articulation UNSC first, then we got some Covenant, we started with Elites, and then we got Grunts and Brutes and Jackals and everything. And now it's new articulation everything, baby. We've got five figures in this team, and they don't come with any of their custom shoulders. Like, a lot of the future teams did come with printed shoulder pieces, but this was, again, the start of Mega new articulation, so their budget was low, but at the same time they provided five figures. Fire teams then scaled down to four and sometimes even three in the future. So five was the sort of the peak there in terms of figure count. And this comes with so many different Halo 4 Mjolnir cores. We've got the Gungnir, Oceanic, Aviator, Enforcer, and Scout. My personal favorite, I gotta love that Halo 4 Scout. I actually think it's a really great mold. I also really do like the Aviator, sort of a nod to old Halo 3 Reach designs. And those shoulders are pretty wild. I don't know what purpose they would have in the game. And the one that's always been hit and miss for me is the Oceanic. Sometimes the visor looks great, sometimes it looks terrible. This one actually looks pretty dang great. But a lot I've got before are so sloppy. This one is fine. And yeah, the Gungnir, I respect the silver visor. You know, they're doing what they can with the actual design. Like, Halo 4's Gungnir doesn't have a visor, so they gotta do something. The painted stripe is okay by me. But a lot of these figures ended up sort of fading into obscurity. You know, when Mega made so many Halo 4 5 sets, there was barely any change in the figures, and you ended up with just hundreds. Like, I literally have hundreds of Halo 4, Halo 5 Spartans, and I can barely tell where they come from, you know? So weapons in this set, we've got a tactical shotgun, SMG, SOCOM pistol, we've got an assault rifle and battle rifle. Most are from Halo 3 kind of style, but this is more like a Halo Reach shotgun, and the SOCOM obviously from Halo 3 ODST. So it is a bit of a random bag. Oh, and we also have a saw there as well. Nice. We have more weapons than actual figures, as well as four grenades, which is very generous for a set, and a missile pod. Missile pods have been a little bit absent from Mega sets recently. They've been in a couple. Foliage, always love to see that. And a load more things. Let's start to put this together. Yeah, I got in contact with a really nice guy on social media, and he wanted to sell me all of them complete, and I couldn't say no. I mean, if you guys have like 100% complete sets that you want to sell me for cheap for videos, then please do contact me. The guy did exactly that, and I was happy to oblige. And yeah, I am recording all of these in bulk before I leave America, just so I have a nice backlog of videos once I get to England. I'm finally going back to the UK after a long time, and I was happy to see the comments section of one of my recent videos was really full of people excited for me to get back to the UK. Like, there's a lot of UK collectors still, and I know that, like, my presence there will help drive collecting in the UK. I'm really going to be focusing my efforts on trying to bring distribution back to the UK. That's something that I want to do a lot in the future. I don't know how this foliage managed to grow on this rock. But anyway, that's still fun. All right, then we've got our Fireteam flag. I love these ones so much. I mean, they're great printed detailing, and you can collect a whole assortment of them if you get them all. Plant that flag there, waving in the breeze. That's very nice. See, the other great thing about these Fireteams is they always come with displays, and usually, more often than not, they come with sandbags, and we love sandbags here. You can, like, quite literally never get enough sandbags in your collection. You'll always need more. Like, every time I'm thinking about, like, my sandbags, I'm like, not that I frequently think about my sandbags, but anytime I, anytime it's a quiet night and I'm thinking about my sandbags, I'm always thinking that that you can always do with more sandbags. And then we've also got a little rod here. This is to clip into the back, but since this set release, what was this, in 2014? Since this set, there have been way more innovative ways of attaching figures, like suspending them from the ground. Like, Mega's clearly thought of better ideas since then. All right, that's our little base plate. Yes, we also do get a little ordnance pod and rockets and a railgun. I've been asleep at the wheel. There's 5 grenades. I was like totally ignoring my space down here. There are 5 grenades and a spanker rocket launcher with a railgun. So there's a lot to offer here. Let's check it all out. All right, so these ordnance pods are always great because you can just insert your weapon in and it is literally like it's been deployed from orbit. I mean, just shout out to the guy sending me a 100% complete set. That's really nice. And you can also, I like in these videos, if you rate down below, did I give the right weapons to the right characters? I mean, the scout, I'm gonna give the SOCOM pistol too, for sure. And the scout can also have the battle rifle. Yeah, I want in these videos to give the Spartans the correct weapon configurations. I don't know as much about what these would have though. What's a Gungnir meant to have? Let's see. So the Gungnir is meant to have heavy weapons like a Spartan laser or a rocket launcher. There we go. Tell you what, if he's got the rocket launcher, why not just have him flying through the air? There we are, very nice. We'll give the Aviator the SMG and an assault rifle in his back. The Oceanic a saw, I think, feels appropriate. If you're underwater in like a glass dome, you don't want to be spraying the saw everywhere. That might be quite dangerous. And our last Spartan for today with the tactical shotgun. And then we've got to pretty much give them all grenades because there's so many grenades spare now. All right, so all of our Spartans are geared up and ready for battle. So let's switch this camera angle and see the display. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Fireteam Venom in all their glory, ready to do battle with the Storm Covenant, the Prometheans, whatever they're told to do. So we got all of these nice Spartans displayed. I also like the Aviator just hanging off the flag there. Really nice Fireteam. You know, one of the basic Fireteams, it was just Mega's first introduction to Fireteams alongside a load of others. And over the next few years, Mega would pump these bad boys out pretty much every 6 months for a few years. So we got a lot of fire teams to cover in the future. I'm going to be doing 3 more in the upcoming future, Crimson, Eagle, and Sierra squad. So please stay tuned for those. Thank you very much for tuning in today. This was another video with The Domain. You stay awesome, you stay safe out there, folks, and let me know down below what you rate this fire team out of 10. Have you managed to bag this before, or is it on your wish list? And the Aviator Spartan is signing off.